Hey everybody, I have not quite figured out my little, hey guys, little YouTuber thing yet, but I'm just gonna show you guys how to get from like your old kind of straight hair into a new look. My hair, it still is good, like it's not dirty, it doesn't need to be washed, but I actually just, it sweat out. I don't want to have to go through and like add heat to my hair for a third time. I'm not doing that. So I'm gonna make like a cute little straight slash curly little look. I don't, whatever, let's just get into it. These things are all like super optional, but this is just what I have to do my hair. Please don't look at my nails. I got hold the day before Thanksgiving, so I can't get in for a few more days. Y'all know I'm not this type of girl. But the first thing I do, playlist, always. Kendall is her name. Hair is the game. Well, the next thing I do, get your thing of choice, okay? I'm using wine for now, but just like chill, okay? When you're trying to do your hair too rushed, it never goes well. Chill, enjoy yourself, give yourself time, okay? Don't try to do nothing in a rush. That's not how we move. Next, you're gonna get your rods. So the rods I'm using are gonna be, this one's for the bottom. They're like, they're not huge, but they're on the bigger side. And then these like kind of medium big ones. So there's not that much difference. Whatever size you use for the bottom, you're gonna wanna go just a little bit smaller for the top, just because it gives it kind of like a layered look, and it's just gonna be more defined at the top. So with the length, by the length of your hair too, okay? Because if your hair is like super long, you're gonna wanna go even a little bigger than this. If your hair is shorter, you might wanna go a little bit smaller, just so that it can have like a good defined look. And the product that I use, you're gonna wanna use a wrapping like foam. A foam, okay? The one I use is this one. This is that B&B. I'm real old school. I like old school stuff. I still use pink oil moisturizer sometimes. Don't drag me. But I just feel like if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And this brand never did me wrong. So this is like it's not pink oil moisturizer, but black people say pink oil moisturizer when they talking about it. I hope y'all know what I'm talking about. But anyways. So yeah, it's just a little foaming little lotion. You do not want a cream product when you're doing this. Your hair is gonna wet up and it's not gonna come out right, okay? Just don't do it, trust me. Just do not do it. And if you do it, don't say that you learned, yo, you got your hair done watching this video, because I ain't tell y'all to do that, okay? The next thing, comb, obviously, little vent brush, okay, cool. And then just some clips. Without further ado, we are going to take one more sip of our wine. We're gonna check our playlist. Make sure you really went through it with the brush. Get it nice and detangled. Again, this is straight hair. Usually when I'm detangling, you know, I'll go, you know, do all that down from the rooter to the tooter, or the tooter to the rooter, actually. The tooter to the rooter. My hair isn't that tangled, so I don't have to do all of that right now. All right. So we got all good, boom. I always just like to start at the bottom. So basically I go like where my ears are in front of each ear, and then I go up and over my ear, down, and then I go to where my fingers match. Okay, and real quick, man, I never meant to cause you no pain. Okay, 'cause what? I just wanna go back to being the same. Only wanna make things right. Okay, so now we got that back here. So now y'all can see my hair looked like it wasn't that frizzy, but yes, these roots for me. So take a little flat clip, boom, just get the hair out the way. You don't want it to be too thin. Because then if it's too thin, your curls are gonna come out too tight. So I'm gonna then part that in half. Make sure it's combed out, okay? This is my kitchen, honey. So this is the part I'll be having to make sure it's straight. Okay, so you take literally like not a lot of mousse, okay? You're actually gonna rub it together in your fingers first, so it's like just a little bit. Take it, kind of rub through the hair, and then saturate the rest to the bottom. Saturate it down to the bottom, okay? You're gonna take one of your bigger ones, start rolling at your hair's shortest layer. Okay, so that's mine. Then you come all the way around to kind of make sure those are tucked. Make sure it's all the way tucked before you start rolling up. So now I'm actually going to coil it up. So you pull a finger here and wrap it under. All the way to here at the top. And then you're gonna pull your rubber band over the top and secure it here. Okay, I'm gonna do one more slow, and then I'm gonna go through the rest of the middle part pretty quick, and then I'll slow it down again when we get to the top. So one more again, saturate it all down to the bottom. Get one of your bigger ones, find your shortest layer. The reason I say your shortest layer is because see how that's trying to come apart right there? It's just way easier to start wrapping when the hair is already together and then to pull the excess. So if you have that out, make sure when you pull with your finger, tuck that in as you roll it. Hopefully you can see me. Cross it over and back. Cool? All right, let's do the rest of this middle part real quick. Change my angle a little so you can kind of see and get all the hair as much as you can, kind of like up into like a ponytail-ish range. So then you start going from the outside. So you work from the back, use your finger or your comb to kind of pull it all little piece to the side. So look, it's not super thin. Then you are going to just again secure your hair. So a little bit. Now I'm gonna get a little bit just to kind of smooth the top part in, but again, going down to our shortest layer, gonna take your smaller one this time. So obviously my shortest layer is different because I'm at the top where my bangs are. If you ever feel like you wrapped around and you're still dry, you can take a little of the foam, kind of like how I'm doing here, just to kind of reinforce over it, and then roll it up the same. Make sure it's really secure and flat in the front, so that it doesn't, you don't have that like puffy root look. We want to actually work whatever you do to one side, you do to the other. Okay, so we did it here, so we're going to come over here. Want to make the part somewhat even. Well, not somewhat even, as even as we can, but same thing as eyebrows. They sisters, not twins. Don't lose your mind about, like, you know, getting a measuring tape, making sure they're the exact same. Just, you know, have sense. Mm-hmm. It's that simple. Okay, so go from lowest layer. Need a little extra love over here. Yep. Boom. All right. Period. Oh, whole shit, I ain't hearing it. Be killing it. So nice and flat, and then boom, secure. Sorry, I'm looking in the mirror and not the phone thing. Also, you want to try to have your rods like the way you want them. Because if you have, or like kind of, you know, angled in, because if you have them like up like straight or too weird, like your curl can come out kind of weird. So trying to like place your rod, you know, be like intentional with the way that you put the rubber band on and where you secure it at. It's not the end of the world. You can always fix stuff and pick stuff, but, you know, just try your best. Sorry, I said that kind of late, huh? It's not the end of the world. Please do not go back and undo your whole head. Like, it's not that deep. So this is when you want to start deciding if you want a middle or a side part. Okay, I think I'm gonna go for like a deep side today. Like, if you want a middle part, make your rods in the middle part, because you do not want to be, you know, having to comb through and part and all those types of things when you first take them out, because that messes with, whoops, yeah, I ain't have nearly enough on this end. Sometimes I don't put enough, but it's always better to like aim on the side of caution and not put as much and add than it is to saturate, because you can add, you cannot take away. Okay, my mom says that all the time when I'm like asking her how to cook stuff. I had to sit for 6.5 months to let that dry. Okay, because you can't take nothing out in the natural world that ain't dry. If you don't listen to nothing I tell you in this whole video, please don't take out nothing that ain't dry. Please figure out another thing to do. Get you a turban, a hat, or if you are going to take it out that's not dry, please be ready to put your hair immediately in a ponytail. Because even if it's cute for a minute, that's, your hair is not about to stay like that. The second it dries, it's going to frizz up. So I don't care what type of hair you got. Y'all a little chain. So this is with all the rods in everywhere, okay, all around. So I'm about to just go about my life for a little bit. Another like an optional tip that you can do if you want, you can like take a blow dryer, or if you have a under the head dryer. I actually have one, but I don't feel like sitting under it. So if you have like anything like that, take your blow dryer, kind of running around your head, just, you know, just like get some heat penetrated, or sit under your dryer. Or they also have those little like hats that hook onto the blow dryers. But I actually just have a few little like things to do around the house, so I'm gonna do that for about like, I would say you can give this, depending on how you want your curl. So I'm just going for like a wave, just a little cute little wave. So I'm gonna take them out in about an hour and a half. The longer that you leave them in, obviously the tighter your curl is going to be. So just kind of judge that by, you know, what you're looking for. And if you take out one and you don't like it, put it back in, then you're good. So I'll be back in like an hour. I hate when I do weird shit like this.
You
only
go to
any
number.
Say hi.
You go to numbers that mean something.
That's just what it's doing. Yep. Okay, I'm back. I ended up doing a whole bunch of other stuff. So it's probably been like, what, like 3 hours-ish? I'm going to use this BioSilk, because it's not like, again, it's not to actually make your hair moisturize or anything. It's just so that like your dry fingers don't make your hair frizzy. So I'm gonna wet your fingers again, just like this much. So now you're gonna separate them. Voila, magic. Hold on. Okay, now, boom. Alrighty, so that concludes this video and how you can turn your old straight hair into a brand new look without having to use any heat. See you guys later. I gotta stop doing that shit.